Hello everyone. So a very warm welcome to everyone who has joined us online today. I hope everyone can hear me fine. This webinar is organized by Seekamentor. We are an online platform that aims to make quality mentorship more accessible and personalized. I am Sahil Baid. I will be your moderator for today, and I am an alumnus of IIM Bangalore. So welcome everyone who is joining in. In our last webinar series, we completed the Career Insight series. We are excited to announce that over the last month, we hosted 6 mentors from institutes like IIM Ahmedabad, IIM Bangalore, SRCC, working with industry leading companies like McKinsey, Microsoft, HUL, ABG, Barclays, and they shared their experiences and key takeaways on, you know, domains ranging from life at B school to their first hand insights into various career options that are present. You can check out our Instagram bio for more details on that. For today, we have the session, How to Ace Your LinkedIn Game. Having a strong LinkedIn presence is the need of the hour, and you know, it might be to catch the eye of a potential recruiter or effectively build your own brand or increase the reach of your network. So without further ado, I'll just add our guest for today.
Hi Sahil.
Hello. Hi Sampark. Are you able to hear me clearly?
Yeah, I can hear you very clearly. Yeah.
Okay. First of all, thank you Sampark for taking out time and conducting this exclusive session for us for Seekamentor and sharing your experiences and your learnings on how to ace the LinkedIn game. It's great to have you here, and thank you so much. For everyone,
thanks to you guys for getting me here. So yeah, thank you Sahil.
No, thank you. And I'll just give a brief about our mentor Sampark. So Sampark is a LinkedIn Spotlight 2019 winner with the likes of Manu Kumar Jain and Ankur Bariku. It is given to the top LinkedIn content creators for the year, and he was among the top 14. He has 62,000 plus organic followers with 25 million plus post views. And he's rated as one of the top 100 marketing and sales growth hackers in India by Paul Wright and Oracle. So it is our, you know, fortunate experience to have you and share your learnings with us, Sampark. And also a quick fact for folks, I have actually worked with Sampark for a year before we shared an organization. So thank you, Sampark, so much.
No, thank you, Sahil. It was a pleasure working with you, and I think this was before your IIM Bangalore days. So it was a fun period then, right?
Yes. So for everyone, how we'll get about starting the structure we have for the seminar today. So we'll be talking mostly about getting to know LinkedIn a little better, how to get noticed on LinkedIn, how to launch your career and build your network and community. So over we'll be covering all of these topics, and we have some questions prepared upfront where we learn about all of this and also from the experiences of Sampark. And then moving forward, we'll also, if there are any questions which the audience has, feel free to type it out over here, and we will try to address that. We had also received some questions from the registration forms, which we'll take up at the end of the session. So without any further delay, Sampark, we'll just start off with our questions. The first question is more about your experience. So how has your journey been on LinkedIn thus far? And, you know, how have you managed to sort of tap the potential LinkedIn has to offer?
So Sahil, while I've been on LinkedIn for over a decade now, but obviously initially it was always like that job search platform that everybody assumes it to be. But I think I would say close to around 5 years back was where I realized that it is so much more than a job search platform. It is so much more where you can build the kind of network that you can. It's so much about building your relationships, building your network, building your, I would say, your own personal brand on the platform. And I think that's the objective with which I've gone over the last 4 years. It's reaching out to people, no matter how awkward it might be now, no matter how odd it might feel, how do you reach out to people? But I think that's how I've gone about it. And so that's been my journey. And once you get hold of it and you understand the actual potential of the platform, I think there's no turning back from there.
Right. So, Sampark, you managed to sort of grow your network to above 260,000 people, and all organically. And you know, your posts, your content have received 25 million plus views over the time, short period of time. So how did you go about this entire process of, you know, building that network and getting that sort of traction on your content?
See, again, so I tell everybody that LinkedIn is a game of only two success mantras. One is patience, and the second is consistency. Initially, am I the only one who's getting that echoing sound, or is it okay at your end? Because I can feel an echo sound at my end when I'm talking.
I'm hearing you fine.
Okay. So the point is, when you start producing content, initially it does not give you result. It takes time. And I give this example everywhere, that joining LinkedIn is like joining a gym. You don't see those results in a day, you see those results in a month. But if you are able to survive for 4, 5 months, 6 months, you will start seeing those results. So it takes a little bit of time. It's a slow burner. But once it catches fire, then it takes time. So what you need to do is just stay patient with it. And you should stick to your game. See, there are a lot. This is the game of hacks and stuff like that. It is not. Personal brand building is not a game of automation. Personal brand building is not a game of bots. Personal brand building is not a short-term game. So you have to survive over a longer period of time. And if I may answer, why personal branding, right? So Sahil, I'll tell you, most of the people who are passing out today, and I'm sure a lot of your audience is young professionals. As they grow older and in the system, they start assuming that the importance that they're getting is because of themselves, while that actual importance is because of the designation that you hold. But kya wo aapko utna importance mil raha hai? Do people know Sahil because of Sahil, or do people know Sahil because of Seekamentor? So that kind of a thing. So you should know that brand has to be you yourself. And because that designation that you are on, or the chair that you're on, in the COVID times, you never know when you might just lose it. So Hence, it's very important for you to, as an individual, to start building a brand. People start recognizing you by yourself. And I think that's a longer term that you have to play. It's not about just looking for a job. People say LinkedIn is a job search platform, LinkedIn is a sales platform. I would say it is neither. It is a personal branding platform. It's a networking platform where jobs and sales are byproducts. If you handle this part well, you will get jobs. If you handle this part well, you will get your sale. So eventually, that's what it is all about.
No, yeah, I think so. So the key summary which we can derive from this, from your experience, has been that, Sampark, that you have to be sort of in the game for a longer period of time. You will not see quick results. You will have to be persistent, I think, is the key takeaway, on how you sort of build your network and build your content. Moving towards knowing more about LinkedIn. So what kind of platform do you think LinkedIn is compared to, say, the other apps we have? How is it different from, a Facebook or a different such a platform which one can use?
So see, if you ask me, see, with Facebook, with Instagram, every potential recruiter or every potential client or every potential business partner may not go and check your Instagram, your Facebook. Yes, if you're in sales like me, yes, we would always check everything about the customer to understand him before we went for a meeting. But every potential recruiter will surely check your LinkedIn. I asked a lot of people, they say, Sampark, LinkedIn is a personal resume or it's your online resume. It's not. It is your personal website. Everybody checks your website before they come and talk to you. So that way, LinkedIn is something that every potential recruiter will check. And plus, with LinkedIn, every activity of yours is visible. Every like, every comment is visible. Your likes, your comments shows a lot about you. So if a recruiter is genuinely looking for you, and as you go up the ladder, they will obviously do a lot of these background checks to see, does the guy fit in culturally? Does this guy's mindset fit in into the organization, etc.? That is where LinkedIn becomes very, very important. I have had friends of mine, yes, LinkedIn friends of mine, who've got jobs without even having to give an interview. Because the MD of one of the conglomerates said, I recognize what your thought process is, what your mindset is by your posts that you've done over the last 365 days. I don't think I need to talk to you and take an interview specifically for this, because interview mein aap 15 minute fake kar sakte ho. But right. 365 days, your mindset and your content, you cannot fake around. Hence, LinkedIn becomes very, very important, because every potential recruiter will surely check LinkedIn out. They may not, because Facebook, you have an option of hiding it up. Instagram, you have the option of putting it into a private mode. LinkedIn, if you put it in private mode, that's game over for you. So right. Let it out. Let people know who you are. What do you stand for? What are your ideals, etc. And I think that's where it matters.
Right. So so we talked about how LinkedIn is compared to other social media apps. Moving more towards talking specifically about LinkedIn and what are the various fields that various things that we share on LinkedIn. The most important part is our own profile, right? And so talking about our own profile, how important do you think is the so our profile has a lot of content, from your name to bio to pick to academics, work ex, certificates, scores, recommendations, etc. So what do you think, how important is the content in all of these that we put inside our personal profile?
See, I'll tell you, so when I do a lot of sessions on LinkedIn, I do a lot of trainings on LinkedIn, I teach people that there are two parts of LinkedIn. One is creating your profile. That's like creating your website. If you don't create your website well and you directly jump to attracting traffic to your website, your conversion will not happen. The bounce rate will be very high. And if you just make your website and you don't market it well, you'll be sitting with a beautiful website with no traffic on it at all. So it's as important to make your profile very, very strong, and then even to market it well to get traffic to the profile. Now, you don't know where that potential recruiter will like out of your profile. And there are so many segments that you can fill it up. Instagram mein dekho, there's a photo, there's a bio, that's it. But agar aap LinkedIn mein dekho, there is so many things. And there are three things which are visible even without coming onto the profile. One is your name, which you can't do anything about. The second is your photograph. There is a limit to which you can Photoshop yourself and turn it around. The third is your headline. Your headline decides if the guy comes to your profile or not. Now, I have seen people putting very, very vague headlines. Thinker, doer, hustler, serial entrepreneur. Guys, those vague terms don't stand for anything. Because how do I know if I go to Sahil's, or if I see Sahil's post or see Sahil's invitation, I should know what Sahil does. And only then will I get tempted to go to Sahil's profile. And then the profile starts working on doing its own work. But the headline is your thumbnail or your hook to pull people to your profile. So your headline has to be very, very specifically written. That's point one. When you go to the profile, there are so many things that are there. You look at the cover picture. 80% of people don't even know that there is a cover picture. Featured section. People tend to ignore it so easily. About section. People have just written one line and left it up. People have just copy-pasted jargon from the internet. Recommendations. There are no recommendations. There are no skills. Guys, every part of your profile, right from the top to the bottom, is very, very, very important. Because, see, when you're going to fight, आप सारे हथियार लेके जाओ ना, आपका कौन सा हथियार चल जाए आपको नहीं पता है, तो आपका रिक्रूटर आपका कौन सा हथियार देखने आएगा आपको आइडिया नहीं है. द पॉइंट इज यू कैन कीप योरसेल्फ प्रिपेयर्ड, एंड दैट्स द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट बॉटम लाइन ऑफ लिंक्डइन. सो इंश्योर एवरी पार्ट ऑफ योर प्रोफाइल टॉक्स अबाउट यू, एवरी पार्ट ऑफ योर प्रोफाइल एड्स वेट टू योर पर्सनैलिटी, एवरी पार्ट ऑफ योर प्रोफाइल टेल्स द रिक्रूटर हु यू आर एंड वॉट यू स्टैंड फॉर. सो द प्रोफाइल इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. हाँ, अगर आप डू अ लॉट ऑफ ऑनलाइन कोर्सेज, लोग बोलते थे भर दो, ये कर दो, अरे क्या भरना है वो भी बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. इट्स नॉट जस्ट अबाउट जस्ट फिलिंग अप योर प्रोफाइल, थिंक अबाउट इट फ्रॉम अ थर्ड पर्सन पर्सपेक्टिव एंड फिल इट अप. सो दैट्स व्हाट इज देयर इन द लिंक्डइन प्रोफाइल बिट ऑफ इट.
राइट. सो या आई थिंक वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट संपर्क व्हिच यू ब्रॉट इज द फर्स्ट ग्लिम्प्स ऑफ व्हाटएवर समवन सीज आउटसाइड इज दैट पर्टिकुलर नेम, फोटो एंड यू नो दैट वन लाइन बायो व्हिच यू पुट देयर, एंड इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू फर्स्ट क्रिएट अ वेरी गुड इंप्रेशन ऑन दैट. So be very specific about what your roles have been and what are you currently doing. It has to be very crisply communicated. A lot of things which I have personally seen is people use a lot of photographs which they probably would use on a Facebook or an Instagram. Most of the people, it's a subconscious thing that you sort of make an assumption on about someone based on their photograph is that as well. So I think even photograph, you would totally agree, is a very important part, to have a very proficient and a formal photograph for LinkedIn, and should not be something very similar to what people may be using on other social media aspects. So I think
No, you're absolutely correct. When you're talking about the profile pic part of it, see, visual is always very, very important. Okay. Now, the point is, what I'm not saying ki ha suit or tie mein photograph dalo, but it should be professional. Your face should be visible. See, because on your profile, it is still somewhat bigger. But if you see it as a post or an invite, it's a very small circle that's there. So it should be well lit, zoomed in, bright photograph. Your face should be visible, should talk about you. See, a lot of people photograph gives a lot of impression, and there are a lot of people jinko photograph dekh ke lagta hai yaar isse baat karne ka mere ko man nahi kar raha, but then I've spoken to those people and like, yaar, this photograph nowhere relates or gives the same vibe as what this guy individual actually is. So photograph is, it talks a lot about you. So yes, pay very, very much attention to these three things. The way it is portrayed, photograph along with the headline, is a big deal breaker if it's not written well.
Right. And then coming to the various sections, you've suggested that people fill out all of these sections. You never know what section might be important, for someone who is maybe potentially recruiting you, or even for someone you want to collaborate with. And sometimes some particular aspect about your profile might actually, click with them or have a common sharing, link with them. So it is advised that you fill out all of these details and not take any section lightly. But it is also that we do not bombard it with a lot of information. It has to be very relevant to probably where you are currently and what you are aspiring to do. So I think that is what,
One thing is that I see a lot of people who even just write things for the heck of it. Don't do that. Okay? Don't fake on the platform. See, I've seen a lot of people who I've somehow realized that they've been faking a lot of things there. I was on the LinkedIn Spotlight. There was somebody who reached out to me and I saw his headline. It was written LinkedIn Spotlight. And I actually asked the guy, I said, "Bhai, I don't see you on the list, but I see a LinkedIn Spotlight on your list." He said, "I didn't make the profile. My friend did. I don't know what it stands for." So again, the moment you caught faking on the platform, it is game over. So don't do that. Don't do that.
Right. So coming on to the next part on your profile, Sampark, a lot of these folks who are our audience and, probably would be seeing the videos afterwards are people who are maybe, just starting off their career after undergraduation or they're in post-graduation. And some of these people might have a LinkedIn profile which was maybe created long time ago and they've not done any activity on it, or probably it is a very new profile. So what suggestion or recommendation would you give to these folks who are sort of at a very novice place when it comes to the LinkedIn profile they have?
See, one thing, so first thing is always keep your profile updated. So that's point one. Second, now then start networking with people. Till the time you reach out to people, you connect with people, it's not going to give you results. And I'll tell you, Sahil, how it works. Now, when I just moved up into something of my own, but I was working with Oyo till recently, I would get over 25 resumes a day. Now, yes, it is very good to say that Sampark, you should help everyone. Sometimes it is not humanly possible to help so many people per day. Now, the fact is, if there are 25 people reaching out to me, my by default bias goes to people jiska naam I at least know of. Now, how do I get to know of names of people? Somebody whose post I have seen, somebody who's commented on my post, somebody who's connected with me. That gives you, so if I see Sahil reaches out to me and I say, "Arey yaar, I recognize somebody by this name of Sahil. I've seen his posts earlier. I've seen comments of his on my post." The natural human instinct is that, yes, out of the 25 people, you might have a higher probability of me replying to you. So the fact is, it's about being in the game. How do you, now somebody who posted, "Nietzsche, what content do you post about?" Write about anything that you stand for. Pehli cheez is about getting consistent on the platform. Yes, I know. And the first thing that people need to stop doing is stop procrastinating. What will people think? My English is so bad. What should I write about? Wo sari cheeze bahar karo. The point is, and I will give you a synopsis of everything. There are days when you get up and you don't feel like going to college, but you do because that's your job. There are days when you get up and you don't feel like going to office, but you do because that's your job. There are days when you will get up and you don't feel like going to LinkedIn, But you should, because self-branding, personal branding, self-marketing is a full-time job. Right. You have to ensure that you spend time on it, even if you don't feel like it. Even if you can't produce content, at least go and put 10 comments on different posts. And a comment does not mean a thumbs up and an awesome post, fantastic post. No. Share your opinion. And guys, you never know which will be a massive turnaround game for you. And I'll give you an example, Sai. I had done a post from a book, an excerpt from a book, tagging the author there. The author is the CEO of one of the top 10 organizations of the country. Okay? He was kind enough to reply to that message of mine, or my post in the comments. Couple of months later, he messaged me saying, I'm coming out with a second book. Can you give me your address? I would love to send that book to you. I got a signed copy of the book from him. A couple of months later, he invited me home for a lunch as well. And I got a chance to interact with not only him, a lot of his colleagues who are CXOs across organizations. And what did I do? It was just one post there. I give you an example of somebody else who got a job without an interview because of his regular content that he's been posting around. So the fact is, it is one, it's rare, but if you are on the platform, you will get numerous of these experiences. There are team members of mine who have messaged me. Then they were not team members, but randomly messaged me at 10 in the night. By 10 in the morning, they had an offer letter in hand. There were people who messaged me on Monday, given an interview on Tuesday, got an offer letter on Wednesday, and Thursday they have joined. So turnarounds happen on the platform. And trust me, it does. I have numerous examples to give to you if I go on to those things. But the fact is, the only thing is be consistent on the platform.
Right. So I really hope that answers Shainam, your question also, is that, you know, you have to be consistent and post about like sort of anything you believe or, you know, you have an opinion on, you know, something which is relevant to what you're planning to do or trying to do. I think once you're consistent and you keep that loop, you never know what clicks and, you know, when that thing sort of grows. So, no, thank you for sharing that example also with us, Sampark. And we sort of move on to the next segment. We talked about how important our profile is. Coming to the second part, as you said, right, the website is there. Now you need to sort of market it and so that get traffic on that website. So we're talking about importance of connections, right? So even once you build a good profile, you need connections. You need people to know about you, to read about your content. So how important do you think this aspect of, you know, having many connections on LinkedIn is? And how should someone approach newer connections?
See, I'll tell you. Now, there are two things. One is about the connection bit of it. Okay? Now, don't add connections just for the heck of it. There are a lot of people who put in the headlines, 15,000 connections, 20,000 connections. It is all irrelevant if you don't know any of those 15,000. The point is, how many of those 15,000 people have you spoken to? How many of those people know who Sampark is? How many of those people recognize Sahil? That is what is important. Now, whom to connect with? Now, there are two, three kinds of people that you will connect with. One is people in your similar genre, but senior to you, so that you can learn from them. So if you're a marketing student or a young marketing professional, add everybody in the marketing field that you look up to, somebody senior in the or your dream organizations, because what they do, what are they posting out, you'll learn. And that adds a lot of weight to your knowledge that you are gaining. So that's point one. Add people who are in your similar genre, but senior, because one, you learn. Second, you start becoming visible with the right set of people. Second, add all your recruits. So if you're looking for a job also in the longer run, it's not ki aaj naukri dhoond raha ho to aaj add karo. Achhe waqt mein bure waqt ki taiyari karo. To jab naukri chahiye hogi to aaj taiyari karke rakho. So add all the relevant HR professionals, recruiters in your genre who are recruiting for your genre. So if you are a marketing student, marketing HR, ones who are recruiting for marketing, there are people who recruit for finance, etc. Jaisa bhi aap, add that set of people. So then you start getting visible to that segment also. The third is if you're intending to do sales. Now, if you're doing B2B sales, I have a client whose product that he sells to corporates. So either you add the procurement people, if your product is, which impacts the procurement people. If your product is something which adds to the HR and the employee engagement people, add those people. So you have to add a mix of people you will learn from, people you will get business from, people whom you will get jobs from. Don't add just helter-skelter. Okay? Haan, initially, you have to pay 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 because you need a network for your content, for the content to start spreading. But consciously, add people where you will learn something, where you will get something in the longer run. Otherwise, it's all a waste. Also, remember, you're talking about 30,000 connections. 30,000 is a big number. So, agar aap sare marketeers aur sare HR ko bhi apne dream companies or prospective companies mein add kar loge, tab bhi bahut space bachti hai. So, be very thoughtful of the kind of people you add. It's a, again, remember, it's a networking platform. Network with the kind of people whom you would want to network, and you will get something in the longer run. Chahe wo business ke taur pe ho, chahe wo naukri ke taur pe ho, chahe wo pure knowledge ke taur pe ho.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I think that actually captures it very nicely in the three buckets which you mentioned, right? It might be to collaborate with someone on a business. It might be a potential distributor. It might be just for consumption also. You know, you want to see their content more and learn from their content. I think these three, if a person fits either of these three sort of verticals, you know, one should go ahead and approach and, you know, connect with that person. But Sampark, so coming on to the follow-up for that question, and this was actually asked by a lot of people through the registration forms also, was that, you know, I send up, I send maybe 10 requests to people who are sort of seniors or sort of distinguished in their field, etc. But I do not hear back from them, or how do I increase my chances? You know, out of a lot of requests they send out, only a few click. So this question was, you know, how do I increase the chances, or, you know, how to increase that someone connects back with me, or, you know, has a conversation with me after that?
Okay. So Sahil, I'll ask the number of people who are there. What is the percentage of your invites which get accepted? If a couple of people can just comment in the box, I'll be able to answer that better. What is the percentage of your invitations which get accepted? If a couple of people can just post it in the comments, it'll be a little easier as well. And I'll give you an answer. I have a very strong answer on how do you get that answer up in terms of your percentage invites. So if I get a couple of answers, I'm... Roughly the people will answer in the 10-20% bracket kind of a thing. So Priyan says 30-40%. So I'll tell you, the point is, China says usually depends on mutual connections. Very frankly, it does not once you scaled up. But I will tell you, the only answer to get more people to accept is send a personalized invite. Every person you connect with, you should send a personalized invite. And I'll tell you why. A lot of times when I get invites, and there are times when I do a session like this, and I do a lot of webinars, I go back, I have 50-60 invites. Now, har baar mere paas har bande ko check karne ke liye na time hota hai, na patience hota hai. So one, your headline and your photograph becomes very, very important, because that's what is visible. Second, if you can send a personalized invite, it gives a lot of context on why Sahil is trying to connect with me. Otherwise, mereko lagega, arey yar, main isko connect karunga na, ye naukri mangega. Arey yar, main isko connect karunga na, to ye mereko agla sales pitch ka message bhej dega. But the point is, Sahil writes that, Sampark, I came across your content here. I loved your thoughts on this process. Would love to connect and learn more from you. Sampark, I realize that we are in a similar field. I would love to exchange notes with you. Would learn to share notes with you. The point is, I understand why you're trying to connect. Aur dusri cheez, jab aap halka se compliment dal do na, to guy becomes anyways vulnerable. Sir, I read your post around COVID-19 and the work from home. I loved that. Right. Sir, I read your article on this website or on this newspaper. I loved your opinion. The moment you give the guy a compliment, agar aapko wo sab nahi pata na, uske post check kar lo. Uske post mein kuch aisa ek theme nikal ke write that. It makes a lot of difference. What difference it makes is you realize that the guy has taken an effort to write to me. Theek hai? And then I'm not saying copy paste similar personalized invite everywhere. Nahi, wo bhi samajh aata hai. Agar aap ek similar template har jagah paste kar do na, to as a person who gets almost 100 invites a day, I recognize that also. But the moment you give a compliment, the guy becomes vulnerable. So automatically, like, yaar, achha aadmi hai, isne mere ko compliment diya, main accept kar leta hu. That's how it is increased. So these are very, very small psychological tactics that you can play around with.
Yeah, and I think someone, you know, it's very well said that it might not just be with LinkedIn, you know, even when you're in a campus and you're doing some recruitment, or you're just maybe, you know, trying to be, you know, increase your professional network outside of LinkedIn also, that incremental effort which you take normally makes you sort of stand apart from these, you know, pools of other applicants or other people who are trying to connect with you. So I think it is very valid, and especially for people who are beginning their career, because they will be connecting with mostly people who are senior to them or more established in their field, it is better to sort of take that extra step, know about that person a little, and sort of convey in a, even a smaller line that, you know, what is the intention behind connecting with that person. So I think that it's actually very valid, and I think this should really improve your chances, of getting a reply back or getting mutually connected with that person. So I think that that really helps us with that question. And I think I see there was one question. I think this is from Priyansh. I think this is coming to from the profile section, which we covered some time back. Is should they be, if you're putting certifications on your profile, should they be diverse or from a specific team?
See, that again depends on, see, everybody has a different objective of coming on LinkedIn. One, just don't do certifications for the heck of it. See, a lot of people say, "Arey, certifications se kuch farak nahi padta," or do more certification matters. See, end of the day, what certification matters is, first, as a, if I'm a potential recruiter and I see that the guy has taken an effort to learn something beyond what he has been doing. Now, the actual impact of it comes in an interview if you're able to talk about it. Haan, LinkedIn is good to give that impact and say, achse, the guy's not been wasting his time. He adds value to himself from time to time. He's updating himself with your information. So now that depends. Agar aapki industry aisi hai, which you can go into varied, there is no harm in doing varied. Now, because today Sahil is into one industry does not mean that he might not have a liking about something else. Even if he's talking about doing a course in photography or public speaking, it shows that the guy has interests and he's working towards upskilling himself. So it can be as diverse. Yes, you, if you're talking about that my industry requires a lot of certifications, etc., wo bhi karo. Koi kharabi nahi hai. Any knowledge is good knowledge. And but the fact is, when you're sitting in an interview and if you put that up, you should be able to answer what you've learned. It is not about just adding number. It's not a number game. It's actually the knowledge game, which you'll be able to talk about when you're conversing with someone.
Right. So yeah, I think very important point on that also, that whatever we put on the profile, there should be sufficient knowledge that we can back it up with. Because, you know, we never know what someone, a potential recruiter might have, you know, looked at, and they can bring it up in future on any interview or something of that sort. So it's very important to not go behind the number, but at least go behind the quantity, the quality of the certifications and, you know, the backing of the knowledge behind that. So, yeah, I think that that answers your question, Priyansh. Thank you. We'll move on to the next most important thing. Probably, I think the reason, I think a lot of activity, I personally felt that, Sampal, that, you know, over the last 3-4 months, social media has sort of boomed. People being online, people creating content has sort of increased. So, and I think, you know, it's one of the impacts of COVID. So how do you think this entire COVID-19 situation has changed the way we see LinkedIn, or the way one should actually see LinkedIn?
See, I'll tell you, Sahil, I'm loving that people are coming onto the platform. My only concern is that people don't fade off as the time progresses. See, over the 4 years, a lot of people say, Sampark, how have you survived 4 years writing every day? The fact is, that is what is giving me results today. And again, I go back to my gym example. Josh Josh mein na sab gym join kar dete 1st January ko. But 1-2 mahine baad na, 80 to 90% people leave it. The fact is, I am happy people have joined it. But the fact is, the result will only come if you survive on the platform. If you drop off after some time, that's a problem. That then you will not get the results out of it. How will COVID-19 and how is this lockdown help? People have realized that it is very, very important. And that's where I said, that is where people have realized that personal branding is very important. Aaj aapke paas naukri hai. Kal agar naukri nahi hai, will you get that same level of importance? And it's the blunt truth that tomorrow a lot of businesses are in trouble. Chahe wo aapka khud ka business ho, chahe aapki job ho, there are a lot of students who have whose internships got revoked. There were a lot of people jinki joinings got postponed. There were a lot of offers which got revoked. The point is, what counts at that time is what is your personal brand and what is the network that you built for yourself. So right. The point is very, very simple, that go onto LinkedIn, you start building your network. Because I'll tell you what's helped me. Maine 3 saal LinkedIn pe sirf network banaya hai. Aaj jab zarurat padi na, I've been able to use that network. You make your plan B when your plan A is going well. If you start making your plan B after plan A fails, then you are in massive trouble. So the point is, this should be an COVID-19 should be an example to people that you never know when things can go wrong. Hence, ensure that you always build your plan B up, and your plan B is your network. How many people do you know? How many people? It's not about how many people you know, how many people know you. That's what is important. So, and everything has moved online. The whole consumption of webinars, Zoom, and GeoMeet, etc., all coming in, it shows that a lot of things are moving online. And I think that's very, very important in the longer run. So people need to realize that LinkedIn is in the phase where Facebook or Instagram used to be 6 years back. Abhi, LinkedIn is the time which will spike up. LinkedIn, when 90 to 95% people are just there, they're not doing anything. And one thing, it is very, very easy to become visible on LinkedIn. There are people, and I have seen a lot of people who are on the call itself right now, who if within the first few posts would get 5,000, 10,000 views. Or kaun se platform pe aapko pehle 5 post mein 5 se 10,000 views ka organic traction milta hai. So the fact is, aaj visibility ban rahi hai. There is still a lot of scope there. So if you go on to other platforms, a lot of platforms have saturated. A lot of people have started moving out of Facebook saying, yaar ye to ab maza hi nahi aata, it's got too overcrowded, etc. LinkedIn abhi bhi waisa nahi hai. So there is a lot of potential there, and it's up to you how you utilize this.
Right. So actually, very important point, Sampark, that you build your plan B when your plan A is going well. And you know, a lot of people will actually see that even, you know, in LinkedIn or in their general life as well, you sort of, the connections you build, the relationships you have, sort of help you later on. And right now, when everyone is sort of moving towards digital, towards an online presence, creating that online brand, especially on professional platforms like LinkedIn, is very important. And tomorrow, you know, that can really help further your career or further your knowledge as well. So I think it's a very good time for people right now to go online, consume content, create content, and, you know, be a part of this LinkedIn community. I think Ruchira has given an example. She got a California project from LinkedIn. Congratulations on that. I have a lot of friends who, you know, got internships in US, in Canada, in Europe, just through applying through LinkedIn as well. So yeah, it you never know what clicks. So it's really important that we start right now and incrementally create that brand about ourselves. There's one question. We had a couple of questions. I think Deeparag had a question more on your journey. Deeparag, we had talked about this in the beginning. If there are any specific questions, we'll take it up in the end as well. Otherwise, we'll share this webinar link with you. There is one question on, how do you handle negative feedback or comments on your post? So I think a lot of people, when you create content, might not receive a welcoming response to that. I think this question is more on that, you know, how do you tackle such a situation?
See, I think Gaurav has very, very clearly answered that question in the chat boxes. Just ignore those comments. I'll tell you, Sahil, the first thing is, you know, we procrastinate a lot. Okay? And I mentioned that earlier as well. Arey, log kya kahenge? Sabse bada rog is kya kahenge log? That's the point. Okay? So you assume that people will talk about a lot of things. Arey, my English is not good. Arey, what will people think? See, point one, Sahil. Agar aap galat cheez likhoge aur gali padegi, to impression kharab hota hai. अगर आपने सही चीज लिखी है और उसमें लोग गाली देते हैं ना, तो देयर आर टू काइंड्स ऑफ पीपल हु गिव अ नेगेटिव फीडबैक. वन इज पीपल हु गिव यू जेन्युइन फीडबैक व्हिच यू शुड एक्सेप्ट एंड यू शुड इंप्रूव योरसेल्फ, एंड देन देयर विल बी अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल हु विल प्रोवोक यू. ठीक है, नाउ व्हाट पोस्ट्स आर यू राइटिंग अबाउट? आई एम वेरी वेरी क्लियर साहिल, इफ यू गो टू माई पोस्ट यू विल नेवर फाइंड एनी नेगेटिव पोस्ट, यू विल नॉट एवर फाइंड कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल ग्रे एरिया पोस्ट व्हिच विल क्रिएट कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी. सी, इट्स योर पर्सनल ब्रांड. If you have a personal opinion, आज पता है होता क्या है लोगों को ना, they have that whole thing of कितने views, कितने likes, कितने comments, उसके लिए they put topics which will get viral. They will put an anti-government post, they will start abusing one organization. अरे लोगों को negativity दिखती है. ठीक है, the point is, if you start putting negative content, immature content, unprofessional content, you will get a lot of flack. And remember, all those flack that you get, or all those so-called awesome engagement that you get on posts such as this, those people are not your target audience.
आप नेगेटिव पोस्ट डालोगे आपको बहुत ट्रैक्शन मिलेगा, बट क्या जो बंदा उस पोस्ट में आपके साथ एंगेज कर रहा है, इज योर प्रोस्पेक्टिव रिक्रूटर? नो. इज योर प्रोस्पेक्टिव क्लाइंट? नो. इज योर प्रोस्पेक्टिव बिजनेस पार्टनर? नो. इस पूरे केस में क्या होगा, योर करेक्ट ऑडियंस विल कम सी दैट पोस्ट एंड नेवर गो बैक. एंड आई गिव यू एन एग्जांपल हियर. देयर वाज समबडी हु केम टू मी, संपर्क, आई वांट टू लर्न लिंक्डइन फ्रॉम यू. I explained to him, the guy went off. I opened his posts, okay? His comments, and you guys will be aware of a lot of stand-up comedians. Atul Khatri is very, very popular on LinkedIn as well. Usne Atul Khatri ke post ke niche galiyan di hui thi. Now, do you think I will ever go and recruit that guy? No. The point is, and I will be very, very blunt. These words are not mine. These words are of somebody else whom I look up to in the coaching industry. He said, their comment shows their upbringing. Your response shows yours. So a prospective recruiter will come. Agar banda ne genuine feedback diya hai aur aapko lagta hai haan aapne galti ki hai, accept it. There was somebody who came back and told me in a post, Sampark, I think you missed a point here. Have you thought over from this angle? And I went and said, yeah, now that I'm thinking of it, I think you're correct. The guy responded back saying, Sampark, I'm amazed that you've accepted that there can be a different thought to it. But the fact is, aaj main ladai karne baith jaun, to phir to gadbad ho jayegi. So negative comments, take it in the stride if it is in the genuine intent. If it is with the provocative intent, just ignore. That's bad. And be very careful of what content you post out. Don't post out content just to get traffic here. Aaj companies ko gaali de do, aaj government ko gaali de do, aaj kuch isko bura keh do, aaj usko bura keh do, bahut traction milta hai. And that is the whole thing on which the media industry survives. Negativity. Don't sell negativity on LinkedIn. LinkedIn is not a negative platform.
Right. So I think very important takeaway, you know, the kind of content you share and, you know, or you engage with is also very important. And the feedback, whatever we get, if it is constructive, accept it, ponder over it, and, you know, make an actionable out of it. Otherwise, if it is just to malign you, just ignore it and move forward is, I think, what the key takeaway is, Sampath. And we'll come back. So I think there is one question, it was repeated before also. How is storytelling important for LinkedIn, and how do you sort of bring that habit of storytelling, good storytelling?
See, I'll tell you why storytelling is important. Okay? It's not that वो चलता बाकी चलता नहीं है, because ज्ञान देने वाले ना वहाँ बहुत लोग हैं. ठीक है? So the point is, stories entice people. ठीक है? When you were kids, you loved listening to stories. And I'll give you another example. हर बंदे को ना, and I'll a lot of people will agree here. A lot of people enjoy watching those late night naptol wale shows which come. Pehle main bahut dukhi tha, fir main bahut upset hua, fir maine ye product use kiya, and then I lived happily ever after. The whole thing is stories. Stories are all about emotions, all about feelings. The moment you do that, you entice that customer. You keep the customer gripped. Otherwise, kya hai na, gyan to sab dete hai wahan pe. Theek hai? So, the point is very, very simple that stories are important because that's the kind of engagement that you're looking at. Hence, if you can put the same message in a story, so there can be two posts. One saying Sahil is a good boy. The other post saying Sahil went out, he saw somebody in need, Sahil helped him. Hence, moral of the story is that Sahil is a good boy. Obviously, the same story will work. Haan, har post story nahi ho sakta. But jahan aap story dal sakte ho, testimonial dal sakte ho, case study dal sakte ho, that is the whole thing. MBA mein case study kyun hota hai? Because right. The story format works. Other than just saying, this is your marketing concept, this is your finance concept. So it's the same as that.
No, very valid. And I think, you know, for the other folks, we'll just park the questions for now. We have some questions to cover and we have around 10-12 minutes remaining. So we'll just cover over those questions and we'll take all the questions, all your questions you have at the end. So Sampark, coming to the next point actually was, when we're talking about content and when we're posting content, there is one question also which is asked is, you know, how frequently should one post content and, you know, how can you retain the audience through that? So that was one question which we got through our registration also.
See, so by thumb rule, you should do one post a day. And I know it is not possible for everybody to do one post a day. So what I tell people is, I said, see, stay when I say consistent, आप एक दिन में एक पोस्ट करो चलेगा, आप दो दिन में एक पोस्ट करो चलेगा, आप तीन दिन एक पोस्ट करो लेकिन चलेगा, बट डू इट ओवर अ लॉन्गर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. सो पहली चीज इज डू बिकम रेगुलर, आफ्टर दैट इंक्रीज योर फ्रीक्वेंसी. सो आइडियली वन पोस्ट अ डे इज द थंब रूल, बट आई नो इन डायरेक्ट आप वन पोस्ट अ डे आ नहीं सकते, तो वंस इन टू डेज भी चलेगा, वंस इन थ्री डेज भी चलेगा. एक बार आपका फ्लो बन गया, then you can increase the number as you go along.
Right. Yeah. Coming to the next question, this was all of we discussed was more from a personal perspective. Coming to, you know, say small startups or groups which are sort of trying to create a presence on LinkedIn, you know, how do you suggest that they, you know, gain that traction, you know, on LinkedIn? How do they get people to be more aware about what they are about? What are they going to say, you know, what are they selling? You know, how do these smaller groups, smaller startups, smaller businesses try to gain their footprint on LinkedIn?
See, the point is simple. Agar aap platform pe ho and you are using it regularly, wo automatically traction aayega. Agar aapki choti bhi team, agar 5 ke 5 ho gaya, 10 ke 10 ho, if you are on the platform, you will start getting visibility. That's the point. Aaj wahan pe visibility dene wale log kam hai. So hence the faster you go out, the better it is, and go all out. If you have a smaller team, everybody goes out. So you get that number of more traction that is there. So post karo, post about the industry that you are in, talk to people, engage with people, do posts, you will get the traction.
Right. Yeah, I think that well, you know, Sampark, and it's important is for the entire team also to leverage their individual brands which they have on LinkedIn. And we, you know, we'll just have touch upon a few more questions which were there in the registration forms, and then we can see if the audience has more questions. So one question was, is it better to write? So these are mostly from people who write long articles, who are bloggers, who are you know, professionally content creators. They have asked that, should we go ahead and write LinkedIn articles, or should we attach external blog sites on our LinkedIn profile?
See, LinkedIn ke post mein, agar aap external link dalte ho, to aapko post nahin chalta hai. Theek hai? Now, if you are the creator of the content yourself, there is no harm in you putting it in articles also and you putting it on your blog also. Articles on LinkedIn don't get too much traction because in the feed, sirf link aata hai. So hence, not everybody clicks on the link unless they genuinely want to consume your content. So articles generally get a little lesser traction. Posts do more. Now the fact is, you're saying ki external blog versus the LinkedIn article, aap dono jagah dal do na. Content ka agar aapka content hai, if you've written it, you have the whole authority to post it out in both places. Then what's the harm? Then you put it out in both the places. So posts will obviously get more traction. But agar aap long articles likh rahe ho, then you can go, if you're writing something very technical or beyond 1300 characters is where you talk about articles. Otherwise, articles mein bahut zyada traction nahi milta hai.
Right. Okay. One more thing was, how do I leverage, so this is by Palak. She's studying in college right now where placement situations might be a little difficult owing to situations, and she's written, how do I leverage LinkedIn to apply to companies that don't generally come to my college for placements?
See, again, Sai, main wahi baat bol raha hu ki agar aap achanak ek din paida ho jaoge aur kisi ko likh doge na ki mere ko naukri de do, to nahi milti hai. Theek hai?
Right.
I tell everybody, theek hai, this is the time to join LinkedIn because next year ki placements are going to be a mess. Okay? I passed out in 2010, just after that 2008-09 crisis, I know how bad placements got. The point is, it is a longer term game. Suddenly, if you come to the platform saying, mere ko job de do, koi nahi dega. If you come with the intention of taking, you will not get it. But if you start working now, you start building your brand, 4 months, 5 months, 6 months, when you need a job at the end of the year, people will know who you are. And I've seen so many students from across colleges who have started that journey because at the end of the year, when you need placements, people on the platform recognize you. You have that base. That is when you reach out to people and people will be very, very happy to give you jobs if there is that availability there. But the fact is, the probability of getting a job that way is better than just appearing one fine day on the platform saying, mere ko naukri de do. You cannot play the victim card. And there are a lot of people who play the victim card on LinkedIn. That does not work. Ek baar chal jayega, baar baar nahi chal.
Right. So I think, yeah, to summarize, you know, it's not a one day, 2 day process, as you mentioned over the last 1 hour as well, is that you have to start now and slowly build it up to sort of so reap the benefits of the platform down the line. And, you know, I think Palak, if she starts today, it's never late. She starts today. and tries to build that profile, tries connecting with potential recruiters in the manner which you've sort of shared with us, I think that could really help moving forward in her professional life as well. We take this one last question which is here, and then I'll also urge folks who are on the live to share, post any questions you have right now. We will be able to take a few of them before sort of we close the webinar for today. So the last question here is, Sampath, someone has written, you know, I currently say if I'm posting something and I've already posted the thing, how do I ensure that I can boost the engagement, boost likes and comments on that post? Or, you know, or if I'm sharing an achievement of mine, most of the audience, you know, this is actually the question two people have asked, Mandar and Mayank, and they've asked that most of the audience, their audience are not engaging a lot on LinkedIn. So once they post, how can they boost their engagement for their posts on LinkedIn?
See, jab aap start karte ho na, aapko engagement nahi milta hai. Theek hai? With time it builds up. You start interacting. Pehle cheez dekho, kis logon ke saath aapne connect kiya. Your connections should be people who are engaging on the platform. Again, when I'm saying that, just don't fill up connections just for the heck of it. Theek hai? So fill up people jinke saath aap genuine, speak to more people, talk to more people. Once you've spoken, if I've spoken to Sahil, the probability of Sahil responding on my engagement increases. That's point one. Haan, agar aap meko chote chote hacks bolo, haan, don't put external URLs in the post. The first 1 hour of engagement matters. So tag a lot of people, tag your friends, etc., who can engage with the post initially. Put relevant hashtags. Don't put hashtags which are irrelevant. Hashtag ki following check karo. Hashtag analysis karo. So hashtag analysis karo. Tag people. Don't put URLs. When you tag people and your friends do that first few comments, etc., LinkedIn senses that the post is running and it gets a little more traction. So if I know Sahil is my friend and I know Sahil ke saath, I can tag Sahil and Sahil will not mind it, tag and let Sahil comment on it. So the moment Sahil comments on it, maybe another somebody from Sahil's network starts seeing it. Dheere dheere, the ball starts rolling, but it starts picking up momentum, and then your posts start picking up traction as well. But don't lose hope. Again, guys, pehle ek do mahine kuch nahi hoga. पहले जब आप जिम जाते हो ना, तो पहले दो महीने कुछ नहीं होता है, सिर्फ हाथ दर्द होता है, पैर दर्द होता है, बहुत डिस्कम्फर्ट होता है. सेम थिंग ऑन लिंक्डइन, पहले दो महीने विल बी वेरी इरिटेटिंग. अरे क्या लिखूं, अरे ये नहीं हो रहा, अरे लाइक नहीं आ रहे. द पॉइंट इज अगेन, बॉटम लाइन इज द सेम, स्टिक ऑन द प्लेटफॉर्म.
राइट,
हर चीज पूरी गीता का सार यही है.
Sampark, and we'll just take the last question. I think we have just the last one is, what has been your biggest challenge in your journey? I think Deeparak has asked that. What has been your biggest challenge on this LinkedIn journey to, you know, from starting from scratch and becoming a LinkedIn Spotlight winner? What would you say has been the most difficult time or the biggest challenge you've faced?
See, the difficult challenge, yes, there is a lot of time where you get a writer's block. Okay. ऐसा नहीं है कि मेरे साथ नहीं होता, ठीक है. लॉट ऑफ पीपल से संपर्क, यू राइट वेरी वेल, आई डोंट कंसीडर माई सेल्फ अ वेरी गुड राइटर, बट द फैक्ट इज दैट यू नो दैट व्हेन आई सेड ना, देयर आर डेज व्हेन यू गेट अप एंड यू डोंट फील लाइक डूइंग इट, बट यू शुड. देयर आर डेज व्हेन यू गेट अप एंड यू आर ब्लैंक, क्या लिखूं मैं. सो यस, दैट होल थिंग. एंड नाउ विद बीइंग देयर ऑन द 4 years ना, नाउ आई स्टार्ट लुकिंग एट एवरी एंगल ऑफ एवरीथिंग दैट आई सी, वॉच, ऑब्जर्व फ्रॉम अ कंटेंट पर्सपेक्टिव ऑल्सो. सो यस, producing that content regularly, day in and day out, every day, is a difficult part of it. But haan, that's a conscious thing that's there. Wo problem kahin pe bhi, aap koi bhi, kisi bhi field mein ho, aapko apni, you have to be at the top of the game. Haan, dusra ab ye ho gaya ki people have started expecting a lot. Ki are Sampark, your every post should get this many like 100 likes. So, theek hai, wo, that pressure is there. But yes, producing content sometimes gets unnerving. But yes, you have to keep reading, you have to keep observing, you have to keep learning, to keep understanding, yaar isse kaise main kuch nikal sakta hu, and I think that works as you go along.
Right. So I think Sampark, we'll actually take this to the last question which we just answered, and close this session because we are almost up with time. And I would again want to thank you and thank you on behalf of the entire team of Seekamentor for, you know, taking out this time, taking out this 1 hour with us and sharing so much of your experience and learning over the years, you know, all succinct into one hour slot. And I hope people who have been here online and people who are watching it afterwards will get a lot of help on how they should build their game on LinkedIn. And for folks, Sampark also takes personalized mentorship sessions. And if there is anyone who wants to, you know, learn more or ask him more about how to build your brand on LinkedIn, etc., please reach out to him. And, you know, any of you have doubts, please reach out to Sampark. He does take mentorship sessions as well. And Sampark, again, thank you from the team of Seekamentor. I hope it has been a great hour for you as well. So thanks a lot.
Thank you, Sahil. It was a pleasure being here. I see a lot of known names as well there, and a lot of new people that I've come across. It was a pleasure being here, Sahil. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sampark. And for folks who are online, Seekamentor will soon start our mentorship sessions and workshops as well. And with such esteemed mentors like Sampark, and you know, stay tuned for more such sessions, more events planned. Follow us on Instagram, follow us on LinkedIn. Just search Seekamentor and you'll find all the relevant details there. And we'll post this link now. Any feedback which you have for this session, please leave you know, it in the comment section, and we will follow up with you on that.
Sahil, I will request people to put in a Insta story regarding this session with the screenshot, if possible. I think that would be really great. At least I'll get the feedback from people as well. If they can just put up a Insta story about the session as well.
Right, people, please do so. You know, share your experiences. Take a screenshot and tag Sampark, tag us, and give your feedback on this as well. And you know, hopefully this is very beneficial to you all. And Sampark, thanks again for taking time out interacting with you soon. And you know, take care. And yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Sahil. Thank you so much.